from a wet and windy Silverstone, we've got the catch-up from the last two rounds of the MotoGP World Championship. Welcome back to After the Flag.
First time this season we get to speak to the world champion, Jorge Lorenzo. Thanks very much for joining us.
You're welcome.
Jorge, what's it been like to be world champion since the end of last year? Have you enjoying your reign with the number one on your bike?
Yes, it's a pleasure to have this number on the bike. But you know, when you put it, you enjoy it. When you are on the bike, you don't see it. So it's the same.
But what about in normal life, back home in Mallorca or in Barcelona? What's it like, you know, going around as the world champion? Have you got any free time?
More or less the same as before make it. No, you have time to rest. You have time to be with your friends. You know, I am the same person. I didn't change anything.
Yeah. What about the start to the season, from testing to the first couple of races? What were your expectations going into the season?
Well, to be honest, I waited a little bit more, not from the results, because the results has been quite well, has been good. Apart from Le Mans, I've done all the podiums possible in these five races, but I waited. I wished a little bit more competitive performance. But anyway, this is the thing it is now in this moment. So we can do so much more.
Yeah, one of the stats that came out was that since Malaysia in 2009, you haven't been outside the top four. So even when you've missed the podium, it was a fourth place. How important is it for you to be so consistent, to keep there, to not crash in races, to keep picking up the results?
Yes. The things change a lot, no? During these years. If you remember when I came into 50, I was a too aggressive rider. I made so many mistakes. I crashed riding by myself, and I also crashed and injured myself riding with the others. And I made a lot of 0 points in a lot of races, no? But then, little by little and injury by injury, I understand that if you want to win a world title, you need to be very consistent, and you need to finish almost all the races. So this is one of the things I changed this last year, mainly in these 2 years. So I got it, no? Maybe I didn't improve so much if we speak about the general speed, because in 2008 I was more or less at the same speed than now, but also I improve a little details and I improve mainly the consistency. No?
Yeah, it's all been consistent up to the. We're going to have a look first of all at the race from Barcelona, the Catalunya Grand Prix. Let's see how things went there for Jorge and all the other riders in Barcelona first of all.
It's round five of the 125cc World Championship here in Barcelona in Spain. Vinales takes the lead to the delight of the crowd of that very difficult turn five, the left-hander. He leads the way after half a lap.
Here comes Tirol down the back straight, and Tirol reclaims the lead as Zarco finally gets through. Now he can set his sights on victory.
Zarco is close, side by side, oh. By actually class. He pushes Tirol onto the grass. Zarco wins the race, but will that race win count?
Well, he pushed him, didn't he? He actually shoved. John, that's an unwritten rule of racing. You don't do that as Vinales comes across the line.
20-second penalty for Zarco. Zarco's grid has been taken away from him. Tirol's Aspar team celebrate yet another victory.
Big wheelie for Aleix Espargaró, trying to get away from the line.
The 125cc champion.
A huge moment. Oh, down goes Takahashi. It was Luthi who tried to hang on, but Takahashi's been brought down with him. Oh, and that's Simon gone down. Sofroblu gone down. But it's going to be Stefan Bradl who wins his third Grand Prix of the season.
Marc Marquez in second place. Aleix Espargaró in third place. 15 riders, we're underway in the drive.
Good start from Simoncelli. Didn't look so good from Stoner as he wheelied away from the line. Here comes Dovizioso, though, through on the inside. Oh, repays the favour that Rossi paid to Lorenzo a couple of years ago, 2009.
Casey Stoner has got up the inside on the Honda. He's got that speed advantage.
Well, that's Hiroshi Aoyama, who's gone down. It's Loris goes to Punia, isn't it? Randy Punia. Casey Stoner, who wins the Catalunya Grand Prix from Jorge Lorenzo. Bench speed in third place.
Jorge, the race in Barcelona we've just seen, it wasn't a classic, was it? It wasn't one that we'll remember for years to come. What about in the race like that? Do you get bored?
Yeah, I almost fall asleep on the bike. I just was, okay, I have to,
but seriously,
to return again.
If you don't have to, you know, obviously at the beginning you were leading and then Casey passed you. For that rest of the race, how do you keep your focus, concentration in a race like this?
You know, I understand that for the public, for the people who watch the race on the TV, maybe it's a little bit worried, and the race itself has been worried because not so much, so many overtakings and always the same position, the same riders, the same gaps. But you know, when you have in front of yourself a rider like Casey pushing so much and being so fast, you don't have time to relax and you don't have time to fall asleep. I'm sorry for the people who watch the race on the TV, but I don't fall asleep.
I'm sure you
do. I enjoying riding at the maximum.
Are you enjoying riding with your rivals on track? There was so much talk at Le Mans about before the race about Simoncelli and the rivalry, but it seems like yourself and Casey get on, some good respect. And obviously after that race in Catalunya, where not too much happened. Is everything calm, much more calm now with all the rivalries, all the talk about the move in Le Mans and things like this?
Yes, I think the situation has going down and has come down because I think Simoncelli will understand. Will understand because the polemic and because what happened, he will understand, and for sure, I'm sure that he will pay more attention, no, in some part of the races and in some part of the moments of the overtakings. I think for this I'm calm and I don't need to be angry or create more polemic. I think from now the situation will be better.
Of course, because of that incident in Le Mans, no Dani Pedrosa in the last race, nor here in Silverstone as well. Casey Stoner missed a race. So you're being consistent and there's other riders missing out. Will that consistency be enough this season, or do you need more?
I don't know. As I always say, when they ask me for the future, I always say the same. I don't know the future, no? I'm a rider. I only know what is going to happen now, this next seconds, and I don't know what is going to happen tomorrow. For sure, I am consistent. We are competitive enough to be more or less always on the podium. But of course, if Casey won't win all the races from now to the end, it's going to be impossible. So let's see what happens. He has been unlucky in Jerez. Danny was unlucky in Le Mans, so for this reason maybe we are leading the championship, but we don't know what is going to happen in the future. If they are going to be unlucky again, or they are going to finish all the races.
Well, thanks very much for joining us. Really interesting to talk to you, and good luck for the rest of the season.
Thank you.
As Jorge said, let's have a see what happened here in Silverstone.
Front row of the grid, Vinales, Tirol and Zarco. Can Zarco get one back on Nico Tirol? We are about to find out here at Silverstone. But Folger now moves into second place. Yeah, Folger round the outside of Nico Tirol into Abbey. 1.5 laps. Does it take longer to really find out how wet and slippery it is?
Johan Zarco going through Vinales, who was in third place, beats himself on the
way up. Volga back in the front.
Yeah, teammate two, Danny Kent reclaims the lead.
And he wins here at Silverstone.
Johan Zarco takes yet another podium. What's turning out to be a great season. And it looks like being a first podium of the season for Hector Fabel. He finally seals it. Away they go. Good start from Marquez. Look out for Aleix Espargaró. He's got a great start. Here comes the Italian now. First chance this season to lead a race.
And here comes Sepondo on spot ready.
Oh, that's Pizzini. That's Mattia Pizzini has crashed out of the lead. Oh, and that's Marquez. Marquez has also gone down. Real drama. Stefan Bradl wins his fourth Grand Prix of the season.
British fans wait. Bradley Smith finishes second here at Silverstone.
Away they go. Oh, look, to get fairly solidly away. Ben Spee seems to have got away quite well.
Surely your best to be out of the front. It looks like a mistake by Lorenzo. And Dovizioso takes over at the front. Stoner has also gone through. It's a crash for Ben Spee. Once again on Dovizioso.
Cimicelli. Oh, it's Lorenzo who goes down, pushing to keep tabs on Andrea Dovizioso.
You would ever wish to see in these conditions.
Oh, Cimicelli's gone down.
AC Stoner wins here at Silverstone.
But Colin Edwards, believe it or not, has taken a podium.
It was a very, very tough race. I think the cold for me was the worst part. You know, the rain continued to come down during the race, and, you know, some of the puddles got deeper and deeper and more difficult. We were aquaplaning more, so it was they were really tough conditions. And also to keep the tyre temperatures up was one of the toughest things. You know, if you slowed down and tried to relax, yeah, that's great, but the more you slowed down, the more tyre temperature went down and the worse it became. So you kind of had to keep the pace, you know, reasonably high to get any feeling from this track. And just in general, very, very happy with the way the race went, and you know, happy just to bring it home and have points, but to come out with the championship leads, awesome.
So as you can see, the rain played a massive part here at Silverstone, and it's still coming down. And thanks to my producers, they've put me out in it now. Thanks, guys. I really do appreciate this one. Not at all. Casey Stoner now on top of the standings by 18 points from Jorge Lorenzo. He leads the championship after Lorenzo's crash. A big turnaround in that. And now Andrea Dovizioso into third and Valentino Rossi into fourth. In fact, it was a great weekend for Dovizioso, not so great for Rossi, but they'll be happy to be moving up, of course. And Dani Pedrosa drops to fifth. Just remains to be seen if he's going to be back in Assen. Now, you've been sending in your questions to us, as ever, at asktheriders@motogp.com. And you sent in some more goodies this week.
It's traction out of the corners. I mean, we've got a great engine, but you've got to be able to put it to the ground. And I think Honda's best point at the moment is how much grip we've got in the rear, and being able to use it, it really does help a lot.
Dream last night. I actually did have a dream, but I can't remember it. I do know I woke up at 3 o'clock, and that was about it. But yeah, I can't remember what it was.
Last night, nothing. Always in the races, normally I dream with the next day, you know? I dream with the bike, and the last night I think I dream with my bike.
I had a crash, I had a hindsight. It's not nice, but it's what sometimes the riders dream.
Guilty pleasure, chocolate. Must eat 3,000 calories of chocolate a day at least, and then so all the training really is on the chocolate, not for anything else.
I like cereal. I can eat cereal 3 meals a day, I swear.
What's your favorite cereal?
All of them. I like them all.
I eat a lot because I like everything to eat, and sometimes I have to stop because if I think to stop, I continue to eat.
No, did not like school at all. I'm not even going to lie about it. I couldn't wait till I got out of school.
No, I prefer to work with the friends, no? Out of the school.
No.
So paddock challenge time in After the Flag, and I've got with me the two rookies of MotoGP, Karel Crutchlow and Karel Abraham. First of all, guys, how is your rookie season going so far this year?
Well, it is not bad. It's quite good. Past few races where we were quite happy with it, just having some troubles, of course, but I think everyone is, so.
And how about you, Cal?
Yeah, it's going okay. Enjoying it, which is the main thing, and yeah, getting to grips with it. You know, some circuits not too bad, and some circuits a lot harder, but yeah, it's nice to be here, and I think it's going well so far.
Okay, well, quiz time. We're going to test and see which of you knows more about MotoGP. So answers when you're ready. First question, how many consecutive championship titles did Mick Doohan get in the 90s? Cal?
I might as well have a go. Three.
No.
Two.
I think we're going to have to give it to Cal for closest answer. The answer
Four.
Is five. Oh. Five consecutive from 94 to 98. So next question.
Sorry, Mick.
With how many points did Jorge Lorenzo win the championship last year? Cal?
383.
383, bang on.
How do you
know that? I looked at the
answer. Okay. When was the last season that China was included on the GP calendar?
2008.
Congratulations, that's right. So 2-1 at the moment. Next question. Out of the 17 races in 125 last year, how many of them were won by a Spanish rider? Karel?
13.
No, Karel?
All of them.
No, but as the closest answer, we'll give that to you. It was 16 out of 17. Agostini currently has the record for world titles in all classes, but how many has he got in all classes?
Is it 17?
No.
10.
Okay, that one goes to Karel then. 15. The answer is 15. Okay, next question. So you're both competing against each other for Rookie of the Year this year, but who won Rookie of the Year in 2009?
I don't know.
Gonna have to pass it over.
Yeah. Is it Kallio?
Yeah, it is Kallio.
Good.
He never put his hand up.
I have.
He did put his hand up.
I did just like this.
So we're at a tiebreaker, three questions each. So this one is the one for the winner. Who was the last person from your respective country? So that would be UK for you, Cal, yeah. And Czech Republic for you. Who was the last person from your country to win a GP? Karel.
It was me.
It was you. Congratulations.
I actually wanted to say someone else because I didn't realise I should say myself. But anyway.
Congratulations. It was you last year in Moto2 in Valencia. Did you know the answer?
No.
You just said it before, Bradley Smith.
Oh, yes,
me. Okay, congratulations, Karel. You are.
Well done, Karel.
Not quite the Rookie of the Year yet, but you're after the flags Rookie of the Year anyway.
We would have given Cal a forfeit for having lost the Paddock Challenge, but I think we'll let him off because of his injury. But we know your game, Cal Crutchlow. No, seriously, we do hope that you get well soon. Just like your teammate, Colin Edwards, of course, took a fabulous podium here, and he even found time to answer some of your problems.
Hey, everybody, Colin Edwards here. You got a problem? Write it in. Here we go, let's answer a few of them. James in Australia. After years of watching me ride and race motorcycles, my wife now refuses to have anything to do with them. How can I get her to become more interested again? It's a tough one, James. Let's see. Give her a little more allowance. Send her to the mall every now and then. Kiss her ass, you know, make her feel like she's wanted, spend some time with her, get her some flowers. You gotta kinda sweet talk her, you gotta smooth that situation and say, honey, we're going to the movies one day and just take her out to the bike track and surprise her. I don't know if that'll work, but give it a shot.
Hi, I'm Helvio De Canello. I'm telemetrist for Marco Simoncelli. And I just like to ask to Colin how to scrap the bike. I'm a big fan of motocross, so I would like to improve my riding style, that's all.
All right, Elvio, you know, this is a tough question. You should probably call up James Stewart or Chad Reed or one of those guys. From what I can see, what it looks like, don't quote me on this, but the guys are, let's say if they're scrubbing left, they're actually kind of turning right up the jump, lay the thing over. This is probably a better question to ask a motocross guy. I got Kevin Windham's number. You want me to give him a call real quick?
Some more gems from Colin next time, so send in your problems to him at asktheriders@motogp.com. That's all from us here at Silverstone. Thank God I'm absolutely freezing. We'll be back with you after the Italian round. We've got Holland and then Italy, and we'll be out with you after the Mugello round, and that should give me enough time to get over this cold and get revenge on my producers. See you then.